States. So this subject is about interconnects. One basic, in electronics. And PGA, PCB interconnects are the most common. We propose a new type of interconnects. This is PGA special PCB interconnects. This is the PGA. That's the PCB. And in between is the stencil. What we propose to put between the two to make a new type of interconnect. Go to the next stage. Next one. So what is a stencil? It is a membrane which we produce in the laboratory using the materials made before used in electronics. So these are given as immersion, cram rubber, and conductive filler. What is cram rubber? It is a recycled product, particles from car tire recycling. So that's a very special industrial zone. What they do, they select tires and they produce cram rubber. So it is particles. If you add this to the membrane, it gives it strength. That's the membrane. With the rubber, it becomes strong enough, but not mechanically strong. Strong enough for this application. So that's the membrane. And the stencil is produced by laser cutting the membrane. And that's the stencil. It fits on top of the PGA. That's the bottom side of the PGA. The PGA is many microbones, spheres, microbones. And then the membrane goes top of it. So what we propose is to put the membrane between the PGA and the PCB. You go to the next one. Now, what we do with PGA, we do what we call this reboiling. We remove the set of the balls and we add a new set when the VGA is folded. And in between, we stick this membrane. You go to the next one. Next one. Now you can either put the membrane directly into the VGA PCB interconnect, or you can do it by casting. The liquid stencil is what will produce the membrane from. It's in this box. The liquid stencil, all the material you need to produce the stencil, the membrane. So we mix the binder, we mix the cram rubber and the conductive filler and produce the membrane. And you can fit the membrane directly into the gap without producing the membrane. This is what is called casting. Then you go to the next stage. Casting is one of the most ancient forms of things. It gets back to the Babylon, the Titan Caves of Babylon. That's where the man started to use casting. We use pots for the flour. And we can use it here for this purpose. And why? Because it is very, very, very cost effective, very low in cost. To fit the stencil between the VGA and the PCB, you need to get special machines. But for this, with this type of casting, you can fit the, you can form the stencil very easily without having any extra material. So what we did, put the next one. In the laboratory, we produced stencils from the membrane, laser cut, laser drill stencils, and fit them into VGA PCB interconnects. Alternatively, we produced interconnect from factory PCBs. After PCBs, I mean PCBs with VGAs that were never folded, always work. So we fitted between the gap, the VGA and the PCB gap, the liquid stencil, which then deforms into a solid stencil and we have the VGA PCB interconnect. So the thing is, whether this works or not. So what we do is we form the main interconnects, we cut them open using a hammer and a chisel, and we look at the structure to see if it works or not. put the next one. That's the structure. The top one is for the main laboratory, VGA specific interconnect, using the membrane, spacing for the membrane, and the one below is from casting. You just feed the interface between the two, the PCB and the VGA in the form of the interconnect. So if we examine the casting, we don't need any microscope, you can see it by eye. But the material fits well, it sticks to the material, and it forms a coating. So you go to the next one. Looking in the photos before, you can say that this stencil surrounds the microbes thermally. In this twist conformation, twist conformation is a very problematic industry by itself. It forms, it is whiskers that fall from the joints and produce the source edges. So this thermal extension fights the formation of whiskers. And with addition, if you try to remove it, it won't come off. And the material appears to be compact. The next one. It absorbs flex. Usually in the industry there are adhesives, but these are not good really. But these are very stiff. But this material is very rubbery, so it's very flexible. So you can flex it. And it is a coating because it goes around the microbes and it surrounds them. It's like a protective coating. It doesn't absorb water or any chemicals. And it is inert material, it stays there for the duration of the computer, of the PCB. It absorbs no water, that's another big advantage, because if you have humidity in the around the PCB, then things go wrong. But in this case, this material, homemade material, the laboratory made material, with the materials never before used in electronics, we find the water problem. It does not drop any water. So even if you have accidentally drop any liquid into the PCB, it won't harm that part of the machine. The next one. This is another, so this box contains the liquid stencil. It's all the material you need to do to mix, produce the membrane. And another material to produce is, again, a laboratory, is called Kappa Phi, thermally conductive material. Now, what happens in the coating, in the stencil, we use the conductive fillers to enhance the conductivity, but these are very expensive. And you can experiment with various types, but they are very, very expensive. You need a large amount, so what do we do? If a stencil has very low ability to absorb and send heat away, what you do is you produce carbon fiber, which is a high thermally conductive viscous paste. That one, we claim it is very high quality because the materials we use to make it are top quality materials, but the cost is very low. So this is, we put on the market and we sell it in over 60 countries globally. So it's very costly. It's very high quality. It's one of the highest kappa in the market. It's about 5, I'll show you now. And we support the claim that this has high kappa productivity, high productivity. We made up our own method. This is the next one. So that's the method. You can read it in the publication in the Pacific book. But that's the method. We do it in air. No machine to use. We use the machine to get to the lab. And that's the instruments you can find in any lab. We do it in air. That's the specimen. Copper, kappa 5, and copper. So it's a sandwich specimen. We feed the hot air and we measure the differences. Then we go to the next one. We use, because we do it in the air, we use a calibration curve. On top is the calibration curve. And this is some data measuring the temperature from the sides. You can find the equation in all physics books, I will come up with this number, experimental number. That's the number. But because we do it in the air, we have no insulation at all whatsoever, we need a calibration curve to convert this into a real kappa, and that's on top of the calibration curve. I don't go through it because that's in the publication, you don't go every detail, something like that. So that's another number with 5. So the number of activity of this material is 5, one of the highest in the market. It is very cheap, less than 5 euro, for the same quality. You can buy for another competitors. And it is a top quality material used. So kappa is 5. In the publication, we made sure that this is the correct number, because we did some tests to verify that this kappa is actually the number we measured. And we think we are correct. And with the next one, this type of stencils we are doing now is the stencils. So what we do at the moment, because we have a laboratory and we repair machines, computers, you can do what you like. So we use the computer customers for experimentation. So we feed the material into the PGA and the PCB, and we monitor customer satisfaction. So we can do that. We have a lot of people. Customers don't know that, but we think that we can do it and we are ready. And we monitor the machines that repair with complaints. Can you go to the next one? That's what we do right now. We don't have any data yet. Now we have data from the previous family of stencils. It's latex acrylic. It is latex acrylic emulsion, a conductive filler, and crown rubber from recycling tires. And we do exactly the same. We monitor for 8 months customer satisfaction. How many computers return with the same fault? So you go to the next one. That's the table. You can do it again in the publication. That's the type of thermal expansion. We do it by casting, because we don't have machines. Machines are very expensive, 50,000 euros and more. And they are very difficult to obtain here. So the casting method, which is the most ancient method man used since the Babylon, as I said, time, we use it now with success. So we feed the liquid stencil, which we sell it. So that's the liquid stencil. It contains the ingredient for somebody to make the membrane. And then if you got a laser, you can do the final stencil. But it's not necessary, because just with the liquid stencil, you have the same result. So if you go to the next, 166 we repaired, and only 6 were out of use. So good thing. Only 6 computers were wasted. So that's not bad. But what is most important is the control stencil. This one is the factory PCBs. So it is a PCB with, as you see from a factory, never went faulty. So we fitted the stencil there in the laboratory, and we have it in our computer for 8 months. No change. So this material is best suited for industry rather than repairing a PGA. Because to repair a PGA, which is very difficult to find, if a PGA goes faulty, you throw the computer away. You go to buy a computer. But we are one of the very few companies in the globe that we do rebuilding. We repair the PGAs. The PGA is the top and the bottom. The bottom side is a set of balls. We remove the balls and put the new ones. So that's the we hope to sell it. We do sell it in 60 countries at the moment, services and this material. And that's the cup of honey. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Is there a very short question, please?
Very short.
If not, thank you. Okay. Oh, thank you.